Ethan. Thank you.
Who the hell else was I gonna choose?
Ethan.
Mia, I know you've been through a lot. We need to talk. You had something to do with all this, didn't you? Look, I just want to know the truth.
Ethan, I honestly don't remember.
Try. Is that the boat? How the fuck did that get here? You're okay. What the hell was that? What the fuck? What is that? What is that?
Mommy. This way.
Hey, what's up everyone? My name is PersNikity and welcome back to Resident Evil 7. This is a section of the game called Direct Ship, and as you saw by the reflection right there, we are actually taking control of Mia. So, in the last video, Ethan had the serum and he decided to save, or I guess I decided to save Mia instead of Zoe. Ultimately, it really doesn't make a huge difference who you choose to save. It's just that when I played the game on normal, I chose to save Zoe. So this time around, I wanted to choose to save Mia. But either way, you're going to come to this part here. You're going to take control of Mia, and you're going to see Ethan right here. He kind of gets abducted by these molded parasite things, which we now know, or which we'll find out, are tied to Evelyn. This is probably, I think, the longest video in the walkthrough. And unfortunately, this level for me is kind of boring. I feel like they dragged it on a bit too long. It's not particularly exciting. The only fun part about it is learning a little bit more about who Evelyn is and what Mia was doing on this ship and how Mia is attached to all this, because Mia's a really cool character. But unfortunately, in this level where we get to play as her, I just wasn't particularly satisfied. And so, because this video is so long, there's not a whole lot. I'm not going to end up... Usually I'll do commentary through the whole thing, but for this, I'm not going to do commentary throughout this whole video. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop in and out momentarily during the really difficult sections, and I'm going to personally, you know, I'll walk you through those sections. But then for parts like this, this is a highly cinematic or atmospheric level, and so I feel like it might be more fun to watch without commentary. So of course there's gonna be the no commentary version, but this version here, there are some really tricky sections in this ship, and so when those sections come up, I'm gonna pop up and I'm gonna leave you with some commentary. But other than that, I'm not gonna leave commentary throughout the whole thing. So real quick before I butt out, I wanna say thanks guys for watching. I hope this video is able to help you out. I hope you enjoy it. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Let me know what you think about doing commentary throughout the whole video versus doing commentary for only pieces of the video. I'd love to know what your thoughts are on that. But yeah, if you enjoy, if this helps you out or anything like that, feel free to like the video, leave a comment below. If you want to stick around on my channel, feel free to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next tough section.
They're dead. They're all dead.
What is it?
The engine room.
What the fuck are you talking about?
She killed them all.
Fuck. What the hell is going on?
We need some weapons. Is there any weapons on this ship?
I don't know, but... Let's go this way. Maybe we can get out of here.
potato?
Are you remembering?
What? What are you?
Said we could be a family.
What are you talking about?
You said!
Wait! Please.
I'm tired of waiting.
Alright guys, so once you get to this point here and Evelyn runs away from you, now you're basically free to explore. Before this, you were kind of restricted to one linear path. Now you kind of have room to explore this entire floor. So your first thing is going to be just to scavenge every room that you can get into. Now you're not going to be able to get into every room, but that's okay for now. Later on you should be able to get into those rooms. But so you're going to probably in this level have to pull up your map frequently. I think it said right now we are on the first floor of this ship, and there are going to be some molded that you have to run away from. So they tend to come up pretty randomly. I wasn't able to figure out a bulletproof pattern for them. But you'll see right here, like I'm in this little laundry room area, and you can find that chemical potion to mix with the herb to create a potion. That's gonna be really helpful because you're basically thrown into this without any supplies. And you see right here, as you're exploring this room, the chances are pretty high that a molded is going to drop from the ceiling. Notice how I skipped that door. That's because you cannot get into that door yet. So don't waste your time trying to get into doors that you can't get into. And as you saw, I turned a corner and another molded started chasing me. And then there's another one right here which ended up getting a hit in on me. So try your best. Really, just get into any safe room that you can. I know that's easier said than done. In this room in particular, there is a tape recorder. So you can save your progress here, but it's still a bit early. You don't want to waste your saves, especially here, because all the tape recorders that you've accumulated so far throughout the game is Ethan. You do not have those in your inventory right now because you're playing as Mia. So you do have to be careful. But basically what you're going to do here is you're going to just explore this entire floor, get as many supplies as you can, read all the files you can, and then basically just watch the gameplay, because what's going to happen is we're going to have to get inside. Basically what we're looking for is there's a door that's locked, and to get in you need a fuse, and so our goal right now is to get that fuse. But before you do that, like I said, you are thrown into this situation without any supplies, so it's definitely a smart idea to search the rooms first for the supplies. And you see here, it's definitely risky. Like, there was no molded in my sight, and somehow I still took a really large hit, and I'm gonna basically be on the verge of death for quite a while now. So, yeah, this part can get sloppy. I don't think it warrants a save. I don't think you need to waste your tape recorder just yet, because you only have to get through this one small section before you kind of trigger the next big area in the level, and you'll get a checkpoint, you'll get an auto save. So if you can make it through this part without saving, I think you'll be better off in the long run of this level. But anyway guys, so do that. Follow the gameplay here. If you get lost, you're gonna see me find a fuse, and then I'm gonna put that fuse into the door so that I can properly proceed throughout the ship.
Thank you.
watch it.
What? Why?
You need to remember, so we can be a family.
You're getting worse.
She must have infected me during the attack. And I'm too far gone anyway. But it serves me right. It's my fault she got out.
Yeah, it is your fault. But that doesn't mean I'm gonna let you die.
She didn't attack you?
It's part of her imprinting protocol. I can't believe this is happening.
Here. Take it. It has her tissue samples. You find her. You fix this.
Okay, Evie. Where are you? She's vomiting. Damn, I'll have to reset.
How's it going?
She's vomiting. Far more in excess of her body mass.
Oh, great. We're gonna be seeing a lot more of her ugly face if this keeps up. All right, we need to find her and fast. This is getting out of hand.
Agreed.
Alright, so after you find that pile of what they call vomit, and after you have that little conversation with, I think his name's Alan, now you're going to have to keep going, and as you turn the corner here, a molded is going to spawn. Again, kind of what you want to do is just, you probably did this already, but just kind of search this entire floor, make sure you didn't miss any supplies or anything like that. And to dodge that molded, so throughout the floor there's these big barricades blocking your passage, but if you duck into these doorways like so, you can get around them. And so what you're shooting for here is this elevator, but you got to be careful because so when you call the elevator, you're going to get in, and when you get in, molded is going to drop from the roof of the elevator, so you got to be ready for that. And basically what you have to do here is lure him away from the elevator so that you can get in safely. So you see there, the molded will drop, turn around and run into this doorway here and shut it behind you. And the reason I'm doing this is because typically I noticed what will happen a lot is the molded will disappear when you shut a door. But in this level, that seems to be a very hit or miss strategy. And sometimes, believe it or not, it actually can play to your advantage when they don't disappear. And you'll see what I mean by that a little later in the video. But either way, it's always useful to just run into this doorway here so that you can kind of properly plan how you're going to get past this molded, because we are going to be very limited on ammo here. And we're going to be using machine gun, and I find that on Madhouse mode, it takes about 30 hits to take out a molded with a machine gun. So you do have to try to spare your ammo as much as possible. You see right there, like, that was kind of stupid of me. I just wasted that ammo for no reason. I didn't need to do that. But so you're going to get into the elevator here, and you're going to... You actually have to manually do this. You have to press the S2 button, and that will take you to the sub-basement 2. I think that's what S2 stands for. And then you'll be able to proceed. And at this point here, you're going to get an auto-save, which will really help you out. Alright, so like I said, at this point you're going to get a checkpoint, and this is where things start to get a little bit more difficult. So this molded is going to come at you from this little side passage right here. Take him out. Like I said, you do want to try to conserve as much ammo as possible, but this is one that it's just more beneficial to take him out, because as you keep on moving up, there's going to be more that spawn that you're going to have to find clever ways to get around. So there's some ammo you can pick up right here, and so when you come into here, one of them's going to drop through the vents in the roof, and so what you're going to do is kind of backtrack a little bit, shut this door, and basically what you're going to try to do is you're just going to run past this guy, because what will happen is when we come back to this location later, he'll actually disappear. So you see here, I'm trying to get him on the right side of the doorway so that when I open it, I can just run down the hallway away from him. But it's just taking a little bit. This is going to be kind of a hit or miss situation. Like I said, it's a lot of these clever situations that will get you out of this alive. But it's really helpful because they can't... You have all the control when you trap them on the other side of the door. There's going to be two bombs right there. Don't worry about them for now. Just keep running away from this guy. Shut the doors behind you, and now we're going to have to do one more little piece of trickery to get to the next section. So keep in mind, too, there's not going to be another save point for quite a while. So all of the stuff you see me doing here, that has to last. That's going to, you're going to have to be really careful. I actually did die at one point after doing quite a bit, and I had to revert all the way back to that autosave location, which really kind of sucked. Now this mold is going to spawn. Lure him around this little, whatever it is, concrete slab in the middle of the room, and run a circle around it, and that's a really easy way to avoid this enemy. Run up the stairs here, run through these double doors, and then same thing, just close them behind you. The molded, for whatever reason, they cannot open doors, so that's really helpful. That means that anytime you're running from them, if you can put a door in between you and the molded, you're pretty much guaranteed safety, unless of course there happen to be more molded on the other side of the door that you trap yourself on. But usually that's not the case, and especially with this walkthrough, I tried to make it as helpful as possible so that if you're stuck in this section, you should be able to bypass it with the right approach, and that's what I'm trying to supply you with here. So when you open this grating here, you're going to get three bottles of acid. And so you've probably noticed that there's doors like this that say you can't open them. This is where the acid comes in. So you're going to pour the acid down, and it will dissolve the mechanism allowing you entrance into the room. And so now, like I said, you probably noticed a few doors like that since the beginning of this level, and that's where the acid now comes into place. So now that we have acid, we can work our way into rooms that we used to not be able to get into, and with that, we can, in those rooms, will most likely be more acid and everything like that. And so right here, you just gotta kind of stall for time and then backtrack, and you'll see Evelyn. You'll see Evelyn in that doorway, and then right here, Mia's just saying, "Oh, Evelyn ran off again. She's making more of the molded," everything like that. So now basically what we're doing is now we're backtracking. So now we are going back to the very beginning of where we got the auto save. And so you can imagine now, once again, all the molded that we bypassed, some of them actually will disappear, but you're still gonna have to do some stuff here. So you see here, there's two molded down there. There's one with only two arms, and there's one that's walking on two legs. So there's different types of molded, as you've most likely discovered so far during your playthrough. There's regular molded, there's the molded that crawl on four legs, there's the molded that crawl on two arms, and then there's the fat molded. So there's quite a variety. For now, we're not going to have to worry about any of the fat guys, thankfully, because those are the toughest ones, in my opinion. But watch what you can do here. Again, you're trying to conserve as much ammo as possible. So what you're going to want to do is let the molded get in front of the doorway, take out your knife, and then what you're going to do is just squat down, push the doors open slightly, and start knifing through the gap and trying to knife both enemies in one swipe. And once in a while, they will be able to get a hit on you, so you see I took a small piece of damage right there. But for the most part, this method is really efficient, and it tends to work really well quite consistently. So that hit I took was pretty rare. That usually doesn't happen to me when I was doing this. But like I said, this is a really good way to just conserve ammo. And you could try to just run past these two guys, but there are a lot of molded in this section, and things can get really kind of stressful when, you know, you're running from two molded, and then another one drops down in front of your path. Well, what do? You instinctively turn around, but then when you turn around, you still got those two that you were currently running from. So in some cases, when you can control the situation, it's better to take them out. Now you saw those two bombs. Now you can feel free to pick those two bombs up, and those bombs are going to be, those are really powerful. If you can time them correctly, they're actually one-hit kills against the molded. And the way you use them is you equip the bomb, you hold left trigger to aim the bomb, and then you press right trigger to set the bomb on the ground, and then you press X to detonate it whenever you want to. So these are really efficient when taking out numerous groups of molded. You'll see me make use of them coming up right now. But basically now, we still have to do some backtracking, and at this point here, there's going to be three molded that we have to worry about. And so check out this really cool strategy I came up with. Once you make your way down this flaming hallway, there's going to be a molded that spawns on the other end. If you want to, you can take him out with the machine gun. It's only him to worry about, so it's nothing too tough. But what I decided to do is shut the door, and then because I planted that bomb on the other side, I detonated it. Unfortunately, he wasn't standing directly over it, so I don't think it was a one-hit kill. Like I said, if you can time those correctly, and if the molded is standing right on top of it, it actually will end up being a one-hit kill, but the majority of the time, it's not. And so another useful thing you can use for the bombs is you don't necessarily have to get a kill with the bomb. Instead, what you can do is use the bomb as kind of a distraction so that you have enough time to get away. And so you see here, I just had to pop out and kind of finish the job with my gun. This guy ended up taking quite a few more hits than I thought he could. But basically what I mean is, let's say you're just going to try to make a run for it, but there's a molded in your way. What you could do is plant the bomb. The explosion will knock the molded off its feet, giving you enough time to kind of run away. So you will, you know, in some cases you will have to use a bomb. But it's not always about the kill. A lot of times it's about just distracting the enemy so you have enough time to run away. And as you advance farther up the hallway, two more molded are going to spawn. Wait for them to step over that bomb, and then just like before, you're going to detonate it. Again, based on timing, you can try to get both molded in the explosion, but chances are that's not going to happen. So what you can do here, and what I'm actually going to do, is I'm going to crack open the door. The molded are both going to be standing on the other side, and so what I'm going to do is crack open the door, place a bomb right there in the crack, and then I'm going to duck back so that the bomb won't hurt me, and then I'm going to shut the door and press detonate, and that should finish both of them off, or at least get them very close to death, where you can just finish the job with your machine gun. Another approach here, if you want, you can try to use the knife. It's a little harder to do that knifing strategy on single doors. It's a lot easier to do on double doors. But you see right there, I just slipped the bomb in the crack, detonated it, and took them both out with one explosion. So I probably didn't even need to waste the machine gun bullets I wasted there. But you can already see just how powerful those time bombs are. And there's actually an achievement related to those bombs. So the achievement is basically if an enemy grabs you, you place the bomb in the enemy while he's grabbing you, and you detonate it remotely while he's holding on to you. And you'll get an achievement for that, but that's something that personally I wouldn't recommend going for during Madhouse, during your Madhouse playthrough, because that can be kind of a tough achievement anyway, and so it just kind of makes it tougher if you do it during your Madhouse playthrough. But yeah, so once you get past this point here, now you're out of the woods for a little bit. That was a pretty difficult section, and so I'll see you in the next tough part.
Emergency safety lockdown system has been engaged.
Alan, where the hell are you? How did you get here?
Where's Evie?
She's out of control. Without the treatments, she's deteriorating.
Well, it's a good thing I'm already dying.
Don't say that.
She trusts you. That little bitch, she never trusts. Okay, wait. Evie, no, Evie.
Alan, listen.
I didn't mean to call you that.
She's
Evie,
trying to take control. You have to fight her. Evelyn, stop. Stop right now.
Don't touch me, don't.
You were right. I did lie to you. I shouldn't have. All I can say is that if you get this, stay away. Forget that you ever knew me. Have a good life.
We'll be together forever.
Do you remember?
Yes, Evelyn. I remember.
Can we be a family like before?
No, Evie. We can't be a family. We were never a family. We will never be a family.
Then I don't need you anymore.
All right, guys, so after all of that, you'll come back to this location here, and this tape recorder, it will now be active, and so this is a good point where I recommend you to save your progress, because we've done quite a lot. This level is a bit more generous with the auto saves than most, but typically I prefer a hard save just in case. I don't know why, sometimes I tend not to trust auto saves, which might be a foolish thing, but I don't know, sometimes I just prefer to have a hard save. Especially if I can spare one. Now, for basically the remainder of this video, we're going to be doing a lot of maintenance work. The game is not very clear on what it is it wants you to do, or like, you have specific objectives, but the ship is so large, it's very easy to get lost, and unfortunately, getting lost can actually be very troublesome, because there's enemies running around. And so if you get lost, it's not just a matter of wasting time. It's also a matter of possibly dying and then having to redo everything all over again. But so what you're going to want to do is go to this elevator here, which is just outside the door where we just saved our progress. And you can see that vent on the floor. Our objective is to get into that vent. But before we can do that, we need a tool. And so we're actually going to have to climb this ladder first to get our hands on that tool. And so we're going to have to go upstairs, and I think upstairs is like the captain's quarters and things like that. And if you have a lockpick, there's actually a cabinet in the captain's quarters that requires a lockpick. I don't believe I open it. I don't think I was able to find a lockpick. So if you are able to find one somewhere in this ship, feel free to leave a comment letting other people know where you found it. But another thing about this level is, personally, I just didn't really like this level. I felt like they dragged it on for too long. This is my only problem with the game. I love the game. This game defied all my expectations, and I think it is going to be a very successful reboot for the Resident Evil gaming franchise. I can see a really bright future ahead for Resident Evil, which really excites me, because I have not been this excited for a Resident Evil game since Resident Evil 4 came out. So this was really cool. I was really glad that this game delivered. And I'm thinking about what I'm going to do is actually do a review. So I've never actually reviewed a game before, but I'm thinking about making a video review for this game. That's how much I like it. Like, I really just kind of want to tell other people about this game so that they'll play it, because it really is, in my opinion, a masterpiece. Is there some flaws? Sure. What game doesn't have flaws? You can argue that even games that get 10 out of 10, even those games might have flaws. But, so I'll definitely talk about that more if I publish my own personal review of this game. But basically, in the captain's quarters, you saw that I picked up the tool that I was talking about. And so now you're going to use that tool right here on the vent, and that's going to allow us to go down into the elevator, where we're actually going to have to do some more maintenance. So what's going to end up happening is, you see right here, this elevator is missing two pieces. It's missing a circuit, what's the word I'm looking for? I can't think of the word I'm looking for, but the little, like, cores. I don't know why I can't think of the word, but it's also missing a power cord. And so we're going to have to go after both of those. It's really frustrating me. For some reason, I can't think of the word of the little small thing that we're going to get, even though we've already gotten, like, numerous of them throughout the game. They're the little tubes that you need to complete the circuit. For some reason, I'm blanking on that word, which unfortunately happens sometimes when you're doing commentary, and it really sucks. But so to get the first item, you have the option of going down or up. That's really just your choice, whichever one. I prefer to go down first, because I feel like the upward section is tougher. So what I like to do is do the down section first, get the item we need, save my progress, and then go for the item in the top part. Like I said, that's completely up to you. You have your choice of which one you want to do. But if you're following the walkthrough, then just know that's how I'm going to do it. And so when you come down here, there's not a whole lot to worry about. There's going to be a couple enemies, and like you saw there, if you duck into a room, chances are that enemy's going to disappear. And so right here, you'll be able to get it. So get that from the doorway there, that little circuit completer. Again, it just said the name and I wasn't looking and I can't remember what they're called. And when you make your way back to the elevator, a molded is going to spawn, and so you're going to want to duck into this doorway here to dodge him. And now with the item in your inventory, that's one of two pieces you need to finish repairing this elevator. So you see here, by ducking inside here, that molded basically seemed to disappear. And what you're going to do, it's not obvious, but look up right here, and it's going to give you the option to climb up into the elevator doorway. And that's actually how you get back up into there. That's really important to know in case an enemy happens to be chasing you. You don't want to panic and forget what you're doing. But there you go. Pop that in there, and now you have one more item to worry about, and that is the power cord. This one's a lot tougher. You're going to go upstairs for this one, and I'm actually going to recommend that you save your progress once you get up here, because this part can be really tough. So you see right here, there's one of the fat molded. Those guys can be extremely dangerous. So if you see him, just run around the other way. And if you really get overwhelmed, you can actually just duck back into the broken elevator, because you see there's numerous of these guys lying around. But another thing you could do, check this out. Really simple approach. Duck into this doorway here. manage your inventory, and then this is actually a pretty good location to save the game. I'll show you a better location to save, but if you want to, you can save here just in case those fat molded are able to get their hands on you. But like I said, there actually will be a slightly better location to save your progress in. So I'll leave that up to you. But I personally, I didn't want to risk it. I didn't want those fat guys to ruin my playthrough. So I decided to save right here, especially because you're able to pick up 3 brand new cassette tapes in this room alone. So that makes it pretty easy. You can definitely spare at least one of those. You can even spare more. I think I ended up finishing. So at this point, I've actually beaten the game on Madhouse, and I'm just going through finishing the commentary. I think I actually finished with like 7 or 8 cassette tapes left over. So I was I used my cassette tapes very sparingly because I didn't know how many I would be able to find. But it turns out they're actually not all that rare. There are quite a few of them throughout the game, so you shouldn't have to worry. And you'll see that I just passed a tape recorder. So you might actually want to save there instead. It really doesn't make that much of a difference. But once you come to this location here, there's going to be a molded crawling on the ground. Really easy way to get past him. Just lure him over here. And again, there's kind of this little desk in the center of the room. And you're going to run a circle around the desk. And then once he gets to this side of it, you're going to make your break for the doorway. So you see here, you get him to this side, make your break for the doorway. You're going to have to use acid on that door, so that will take a second, but don't worry, you should have plenty of enough time to get through the doorway unharmed. And now this is where things get really tough, so hopefully you have a time bomb or two left in your inventory, but basically what's going to happen here is once you start trying to disconnect the power cord, so the power cord has like 2 screws on it, and once you start trying to disconnect that, a fat molded and a crawling, and a regular molded are going to come after you. So what you're going to want to do is run over to the power cord, unscrew one of them, unscrew the second one, and then run away. You probably won't have enough time to grab the power cord itself. That's okay. What you're going to want to do here is run away. So run in a big circle. Try to get around that guy. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Don't panic. Just try your hardest to get out of that room. And once you're out of that room, you're going to run back down this hallway here, set a bomb in place, and then hide at the end. And if you're lucky, the molded will be the one that follows you because they'll actually get killed by that explosion. But unfortunately, I had the barfing guy follow me, and that made things tougher for me because that guy will not die just from the explosion. So if you run out of the bombs, then what you're just going to want to do is kind of revert back here. And I basically ducked in here because I got overwhelmed. I wasn't sure how I wanted to proceed. I actually considered restarting the checkpoint. But what I'm going to do here is now, since both of the enemies are on the other side of this doorway, now I'm going to make a break for it. So I'm going to pop open this doorway. If you want to, you can try to knife them to death through the doorway. It turns out you don't have to, but that's definitely an option. But you can see here, like, the barfing guys are just really, really hard to kill because their barf, if even a small piece gets on you, it'll do a lot of damage. And if it goes through the wall, I think that's just a glitch in the game. I don't think that can hurt you, but if you crack open the doorway and try to knife him, it can hurt you, as you saw right there. And so you'll see here, I am on a very low piece of health, and I'm still running away from that guy. I'm limping, but I'm just basically making my break for it. So I'm gonna dodge this guy, run back into here, grab the power cord, turn around, and now I have to successfully dodge both guys on my way out. That guy's not hard to dodge. The barfing guy is. That's definitely the hardest guy to dodge. But if you get around him, he is really slow. And so if you're able to get around him, you should be able to run back with no problem. And keep in mind, I did that very sloppily. I took some hits I probably shouldn't have taken. So if you're a little bit more careful than I was, you'll probably be able to get through that with much more health than I have. And that's going to be actually pretty useful coming up. So if you have any health potions, definitely use them right now. And I know we just saved our progress a little while ago, but because we picked up 3 cassette tapes, I'm actually going to recommend you save once again. So I'm going to recommend you save right here. And what you're going to see is I actually decide to create a new save file. And that's because I knew that I had really low health right here, and I knew that there was a tough section coming up. So the reason I did that was so that I didn't get stuck. You know, say I'm not able to get through the really tough section with this small amount of health. Well, then what I would just do is load up my old save file and just do that section over again so that I guarantee myself a bit more health. So creating that extra save file was just as a basically piece of insurance that I was able to get through the final section with the small amount of health that I had. Because now what you're going to do, you're basically making your final break for it, and if you can get through this, you're going to be fine and you're going to be done with the wrecked ship section. So go to the floor S2. That's where Ethan is currently being held. And now we're going to try our best to save him. And so this is where... I'll get to that in a second. As you make your break for Ethan, you're going to get attacked by multiple molded. And this is what I was talking about. Like, I had so little health that this section made me really nervous. Because basically, if I took one or two hits, I was going to be killed. And that's why I created the extra save file, just as a little piece of insurance. But you can see here, I'm just running. I'm able to run past most of these enemies. That guy was able to get a hit on me, and I was so, so close to dying. But thankfully, most of the enemies are relatively easy to dodge. So if you start off with more health than I did, you'll definitely be fine. But keep in mind, it is helpful to save before rushing into this section, just in case. But if you get to this room here, give yourself a pat on the back because... you've done it. And this is where saving Mia or Zoe comes into play, so I'll let you watch this cutscene and then I'll talk about it.
Ethan? Hey, shh, I know. I'm not gonna hurt you. Hell, I never would have if I could have helped you.
What do you mean?
I'm no killer, son. Neither is Marguerite, nor my boy Lucas, or even Zoe here. That girl Evelyn, she did this.
What the hell is she? Now, what did she do to you?
She infected us with her gift. That's what she calls it. I found her near a busted out tank in the bayou. Everything changed after that.
So she infects you and then she takes control?
No. Not exactly, son. She just... She forces her way into your mind, your soul. You can't fight back. You are connected to her and you can't resist the urge to... Oh, you're a different person after that.
Just like Mia. So Mia sent me that message because of Evelyn.
Listen, a girl just wants a family of her own. She's the key, all right? You find her, and you stop her. Ethan. Free my family. Please.
All right, guys, so basically I just want to kind of elaborate. Earlier in the game, you had a choice to save Mia or Zoe. On my original playthrough, I saved Zoe. And what happens here is when Mia digs you out of this thing, she gets angry at you for saving Zoe, and you actually will have to fight her. Now, that fight is really easy. It's not difficult at all, but it is still a fight. Whereas if you choose to save Mia, in this part right here, you won't have to fight her. And so that's just, you know, like I said, it's not a difficult fight, but if you save Mia, that's one less fight to worry about, which is always useful. And so I kind of recommend on your Madhouse playthrough you choose to save Mia, but on your normal playthrough you choose to save Zoe. Personally, I feel like you should just save Zoe. But so you see right here, like, Mia is pushing me through this doorway, and she's giving me this thing, and she pushes me through the door to guarantee my safety. If you had chosen to save Zoe, I would have had to fight her right now. instead of her saving me like she did. Now, personally, if you guys care, in my opinion, I feel like you should save Zoe. And that's because, first off, Mia, as you learn in this video, Mia actually had kind of a role to play with Evelyn, which makes her a little bit shady. But the other thing is, I was just... In the beginning of the game, when you have to fight Mia, she was so hard to take down. Like, I just got really pissed. And the other thing is, look at Zoe. Like, Zoe is a part of the Baker family. But she puts her life on the line to save you, to find the cure. And so that's why in my original playthrough, I chose to save Zoe without any hesitation. But another reason I chose to save Mia in this playthrough was to get the achievement. Because based on who you save, you'll get a different ending. So there's two different endings you can get. And there's an achievement related to both ones. So eventually you're going to want to save both of them. Personally, I prefer saving Zoe. But on your Madhouse mode, you might want to save Mia. So thanks for watching, guys. Like and subscribe if you get the chance. And I'll see you in the next video as we take on the salt mines.